welcome to Sonic Odyssey, the video channel dedicated to bringing you the last 50 years or so of music in review and discussion format to hopefully open up a discussion and maybe open some doors on some music that you might not be familiar with. Before we begin, I'd like to ask you to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. The like button is right below the video with a little thumbs up sign, and the subscribe button will keep you notified each time I post a new video. Also, if you feel so inclined, you could visit our Patreon page. I don't make any ad revenue from YouTube because my videos include music snippets from the albums I discuss, and therefore I make no profits from YouTube. I have no revenue from YouTube, but I do have the Patreon page set up, so those people who are so inclined that feel the channel is worthwhile can maybe dedicate a few dollars a month. Anything from a couple of dollars a month upwards would really be a great help and greatly appreciated. Okay. Today we're going to be looking at an album from 1993 and from one of my personal favorite songwriter musicians of all time. I've been following him since the late 1970s, and his music has always been provocative and thought-provoking. The album we're going to be looking at today is called Wildwood, and the artist is Paul Weller. This is Paul Weller's second solo album, and it reached number two on the UK charts. It had three singles that all were in the top 16, including Wildwood, Sunflower, and Hung Up. All of those songs have their own distinct characteristics, and that's one of the things about the album Wildwood itself as well. Wildwood is a very broad-reaching album. It has everything from just simple acoustic guitar pieces to full-on rhythm and blues, pop rock style, but it's mostly a fairly mellow album for the most part. There's nothing that's heavy or jamming. It's all just really good music, the kind of music you can dim the lights to, put on, drink a bottle of wine, and have a nice romantic evening. Before we get any further into the discussion of the album, probably we should give a little bit of a listen to some of it. And for the first sound snippet that I've chosen, I've taken the song All the Pictures on the Wall. And this is a beautiful song with a heartbreaking underscore to it. So let's give a slight listen to All the Pictures on the Wall.
All the pictures on the wall.
Pictures on the Wall is a nice, mellow, mid-tempo, easy-going, easy-rock kind of song. It has a really beautiful way of describing a lamentation of a relationship that is turned sour, and how all the pictures on the wall serve only to remind us of it all. It's got a way of reaching into you and making you feel what the artist himself is feeling at that juncture, at that time. So it's a piece that serves as a reminder of those things that were once so beautiful but have now become sad reminders of what once was. Wildwood, as an album by itself, is pretty much a mix of rock styles, but as I say, it's really a very mellow album. There's nothing heavy, there's no heavy, hard rock songs at all on the album. It's all presented in a very from simple acoustic to simple pop stylings. The album has not only the songs that were the successful singles from the album, but also has some beautiful pieces and reminisces and reprises from earlier pieces of the songs within the album. And so it's a very tightly constructed and cohesive listening experience. You never feel jarred going from one track to the next. Everything feels very organic and very fluid. Wildwood has the song Holy Man on it, which is Can You Heal Us, Holy Man? Holy Man. And that song is a very moving piece trying to restore faith, restore a sense of rightness amidst all the chaos. And there are lots of songs. There's 16 songs in total on the album, including three instrumental pieces that serve as bridges between a few of the songs. Instrumental 1, Instrumental 2, and Instrumental 1 Part 2. They all serve as fantastic musical interludes between the different songs and bridges for those songs. So for the last musical snippet, I chose probably my favorite song on the album. It's called Moon on Your Pajamas, and it is a beautiful song, a love song. And why don't we give a brief listen to it before we go any further? So here's Moon on Your Pajamas.
Is that a shooting star I saw? It's fair for me to make a wish at all. Dangerous times. we are barely afloat. And I hope the world will heal itself. I want our souls along with him, so that you get the chance to say that you have seen a better day.
Moon on Your Pajamas is an adoring ballad to a parent looking over his child lying in bed and seeing the moonlight. You can imagine the moonlight coming in through the window and the light reflecting on the pajamas and on a mobile hanging above the bed. And it really is a beautiful moment in time, a snapshot of the affection and adoration that this parent has for his child. Beautiful stuff. And for over 27 years now, this song has been one of my favorite songs of all time. Wildwood is fairly representative of what Paul Weller has done with much of his solo career. The album has a huge array of musical instruments. Paul Weller himself plays guitar, bass, piano, mellotron, moog, harp, harmonica, and a few other instruments as well. He's got a list of, I think, 12 or so instruments that he plays on the album. And that's not uncommon for Paul Weller. He's a multi-musician, musicianist, and he loves to have the sonic landscape of his songs be rich and full and representative, and sometimes unexpected. So Paul Weller really knows how to put together quite a fantastic solo album. He's, I think, done 13 solo albums since 1991. So that's Paul Weller's Wildwood. I definitely give it 5 out of 5 stars. It is simply a masterpiece to listen to, and a wonderful, easy listening, peaceful, and all over emotional experience. So, thank you very much for tuning in to Sonic Odyssey today, and please remember to consider visiting our Patreon page, and also like and subscribe to the channel, and until next time, I'll see you then. Bye.